What's up, guys? It's Jay. More than Anthrakill, and I'm back here on the Borderlands pre-sequel. And today, I'm going to show you an Easter egg inside the game that goes beyond just being an Easter egg for me. This Easter egg is a little bit special, and I'm pretty sure that's the reason that this Easter egg actually ended up inside the game, because most of the developers and writers for Gearbox and 2K should be just around my age. I'm 31 years old, so I'm pretty sure they're either going to be somewhere in their early 30s, maybe a little bit older, but the one thing that I'm pretty sure that I have in common with a lot of the developers at Gearbox and 2K is that we all grew up in the 80s. We experienced the decade known as the 1980s. It was a hell of a time. So, if you grew up in the 80s, there's a few iconic moments growing up that you really remember that stick out of your head. I mean, you had the whole summer where there was nothing but the Batman symbol all over. Those of you guys that are growing up now know exactly what I mean, because you had the recent Batman trilogy. But we had our first Batman movie back in the 80s. Then we had the San Francisco earthquake, the fall of the Berlin Wall. You have Phil Simms yelling, "I'm going to Disney World!" And that was the first time that's actually happened in sports history. And now that's actually a proud tradition inside of American sporting events to go ahead and yell the whole, "I'm going to Disney World!" when you win a championship. So, anyway, all that pales in comparison when you have the moment where you first saw E.T. and Elliot escape the government on the bicycle. And it was that moment when you saw E.T. and Elliot just soar through the air past the government. It was absolutely amazing. Because up until that point, not only did we not really have any believable-looking alien movies, but, you know, for the first time, the alien meant us no harm. We were actually the enemy inside of E.T., and it was just an unbelievable movie at the time with some incredible moments. And, you know, the moment where they fly across the moon is probably one of the most iconic moments in cinema history, actually. So it's that moment that we're going to recreate inside this game. So now that you've seen the gameplay on the screen, you know by now that we're in the Lunar Launching Station and we're just below the fast travel where Jack is standing overlooking the area. So to do this Easter egg and get yourself the best possible viewpoint for this Easter egg, you're gonna want to clear out this entire area, every single enemy. Trust me, it's gonna make life easier. And I'm not just talking about the enemies below Handsome Jack's office. I'm talking about the entire area, up the stairs, around the corner, out in the courtyard where we had to blow up the fuses and stop the laser, right? You remember all that? Yes, well, clear that whole area out. And then once you've done that, I'm going to show you exactly where you need to go from Jack's office at the fast travel. So once you're at the fast travel, you're going to want to go down this whole incline. Be careful, though, because this actually is an elevator and it'll push you back up. Found that out the hard way. So you're going to want to go down through the elevator and immediately hook a left. And then you're going to go around the corner and up a few sets of stairs there. Now, once you get up the stairs, you're going to notice that there is a decommissioned robot there. And there's going to be a table next to him with a briefcase. And you can actually push a button inside the briefcase. And nothing happens. Except something actually does. So, what you're going to do is, you can either head out the danger tunnel into the main area that's right behind you, or you could run all the way back to where Jack is standing for a better viewpoint. Either way, you're going to get a pretty good view of the Easter egg. But once you go outside, you will notice if you look at the moon, there is a slow-moving silhouette of a claptrap in a basket that's attached to the handlebars of a bicycle being driven by a loader. And you get to recreate this awesome, iconic, cinematic moment inside of Borderlands, and it's Borderlands themed too, the claptrap and the loader, and it's absolutely amazing. And I gotta give it to Gearbox and 2K. You know, each Easter egg that I come across inside this game, it just keeps getting better and better. But I do want to thank Mr. Toxic Moab from Twitter. He gave me some really vague instructions, but his information was good. I found out where to go, you know, by his instructions. It wasn't the greatest instructions, Mr. Toxic Moab, but I do thank you, because I get to share this awesome Easter egg with you. Not only that, but I get to be the first on YouTube with this Easter egg, because I searched. Oh, motherfuckers, don't tell me. I searched and made sure. I was like, anybody else got this Easter egg out there? I went clickety-clack on the keyboard. I didn't see anything. So, I want to thank you guys for watching. Make sure you guys rate, comment, subscribe. If you could leave a thumbs up on the video, I'd highly appreciate it, because it gives me motivation to make more videos for you motherfuckers that watch my motherfucking videos. E.T. the Extraterrestrial Easter egg inside of Borderlands the pre-sequel. You can't get any better than that. Or can we? If you subscribe, we'll figure that out in the next few days. So, like I said, my name's Jay. We're gonna have to kill. Thanks for watching, and I'm gonna see you guys later.